Well, breaking news. Wait, guys, listen. It has been reported. I'm going to go through this. It has been reported that, look, one of Jacob Zuma's child is going to be married to King Mswati. Well, it's not, look, okay, maybe let me say she's going to be married to King Mswati. Maybe let me say there is a potential that she will be married to King Mswati. Now, where do we gather all these things and now coming up with a story of potential and everything? Well, that is very simple. This is what is basically happening. There is a delegation that has been sent, and I'm going to be reading this. You know, I was browsing somewhere on Twitter, on the street of Twitter. Right, I came across an article that comes directly from the kingdom of Eswatini. Right, the article was released on the 6th of July, 2024, right? Which was Saturday. It says, look, it was released on Saturday, 6th of July, 2024, and then by Zweli Martin Dlamini. The article says, revealed King Mswati wants to marry 21-year-old Jacob Zuma's daughter as the next wife. Reluctantly, former president snaps Gutela family meetings, right? So, okay, I know you say, Bongs, wait a minute. What's up with this? Well, is it the age? Is it the, look, personally, I don't know what to think about the age. Because remember that at the age of 18, you can marry anyone of your choice, right? You can take your own decisions. For instance, others who might want to decide to fall into the group of people who belong into the LGBTQI, they may decide to do so to such an extent that they can even change their agenda because the agenda, right? As me, look, you know me, Bongan Masugu. Look, because I'm old, I can look, because now I'm only interested in women. But because of the age, tomorrow, a man like me can wake up and say, listen, I'm now a female, and they go and terminate my male part, and then they put a male. Like a female private part. It does happen now. And then suddenly you see me developing certain things in my body because of the chemicals as well that would have been given to me. Such is the benefit that comes with a certain age. When you get to a certain age, you are allowed to make decisions for your own. So if you take what I've just said and the fact that the underlining key points there is that you are of an age where you can make decisions of your own. You can then go back to the Jacob Zuma's daughter and say she's 21. She can make a decision to marry the king. Why not? Because of the age. But I've got my own concerns, right? And I want us to address those things. Tell me whether I'm being realistic or not. But before we dive into that, well, I don't want you to be unrealistic to such an extent that you don't do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contributing to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, so the article written, Mbabane, King Mswati allegedly sent a delegation of traditionalists to Jacob Zuma's home, KwaZulu-Natal, last weekend to present 10 kekle as part of Gutela customary practice. The king was seeking permission to marry former president Jacob Zuma's daughter, Nomcebo Zuma, 21. But the former president is alleged to have refused to attend the meeting organized for Gutela as she felt betrayed by his friend. Yo, Kucela is a Swati word that is context. It means seeking permission and blessing from the local elders before marrying their daughter. Mswati is an absolute monarch and a polygamist which have... Listen to this one. This is where my problem starts. King Mswati is an absolute monarch and polygamist with over 15 wives. 15. Literally one plus five wives. And you still want to marry a 21-year-old baby. I don't get it. Like, what are you going to be doing there? For what? 15 wives. Guys, let's be realistic. He's a king. We get it. But this is where my problem starts. But let's proceed. Wife who's alleged to have first told Jacob Zuma that the daughter will be married by one of his sons, to which Zuma agreed. But the king subsequently changed his mind, seeking to take Nomcebo Zuma for himself. Reached for comment by this Swazi News on Friday. King spokesperson Percy Simelane said he was not aware of the proposed marriage between Mswati and Zuma's daughter. And then this is, I quote, "We are not aware of any pointers of that effect," said the king's spokesperson. But one of king's wife confirmed that Mswati was preparing to marry Jacob Zuma's daughter and considering to take Inkosigati. The delegation of traditionalists have left the country last weekend to KwaZulu-Natal, organized by king's emissary, Tula Dlamini, on behalf of the king. Right? I quote, "It's surprising because some of us spent years without seeing him. We only watch him on TV, and now he wants to add another wife," said one of the king's wife who asked the local this journalist to strictly protect her name as a matter remains highly sensitive. You see, I think that is what is being raised here. I was going to raise it later on. That's why I said, let me continue. It can't be that at the you already have 15 wives, and there you are still pursuing a young wife. Okay, fine. After getting married to her, you're going to give her attention. But again, the problem is here. When you get somebody that, one day you will see a 19-year-old lady, you still want to marry her, the attention, you will stop paying attention to this one now because there's now a new one. A new broom sweep better than the old one. It's a known fact. So I am not, I don't get it. I don't understand. I don't get it. I'm not in support of it at all. If probably, by the way, I'm not a traditionalist in the sense that, I wouldn't take polygamy myself. But to people that will take polygamy themselves, I'm trying to be logical here. I'm trying to be realistic here. I was going to raise this point to say, how do you manage these 15 wives? How to satisfy them? Now they are saying others, it's been years. Chances are probably they are exaggerating. And I can tell you that for a fact that probably they are exaggerating, but probably they are telling the truth as well. So I will not behave like feminists who will say, let's just believe them, that they are telling the truth, because chances are she last saw him 1 year ago. Then she will say yes, because you know what I'm saying, it's been a while. Maybe it does happen as well. So with me, I'm 50-50 with regards to we only see him on television. I'm just 50-50 there. But truth be told, and I'm not going to back down on this one, right? I do not understand why an old man, an old man of that caliber will marry a young child like this. No. The newspaper continues to say, this Swaziland News is
in position of information where another king's wife was expressing her frustration to a relative. She told the relative that she asked her husband, and he confirmed that indeed Nomcebo will be the new Lipovela, right? Okay. The wife says, he told me that he is strengthening relationships with Zuma. Can you imagine? The king's wife told a relative. One of Zuma's wife also confirmed that Mswati sent a delegation seeking a permission to marry the former president's daughter. Effort to reach the former president's spokesperson proved unsuccessful at the time of compiling this report. Guys, the daughter, she's old enough to make decisions, right? Remember, I started with that. She might probably think that from a competition point of view, she might think of herself as, you know what, I'm going to compete. I'm going to win the man to myself. The problem is the longevity of that. Because the king doesn't seem to come to a point where he takes enough wives. And, you know, because, guys, let's face it. There will always be a beautiful woman somewhere, somehow. Guys, I can guarantee you. And have you noticed this? When you are in a relationship, for instance, you are single. So you're not dating anybody. You're not seeing anyone. You're just single. I'll tell you something. There are things that you don't face. And then this other person as well, this other lady in your very circle is single. There are temptations you don't face. But the moment you date, the moment you get into a relationship, now this lady, this one wants the same person. Now suddenly people see this lady in a different light. Now everybody wants to date her. And you as a man, suddenly all these ladies, now they want you. Like, you know what I'm saying? So every relationship will go through that. But what I'm saying is, as a person, you then have to make the decisions to say, no, man. No, I can't live by this. You know, I can't entertain this. So, in other words, you must get to a point where you have a sense of, if discipline, yes, it's discipline, it's commitment, and it is, I'm looking for this English word, I forgot, but contentment, yes, that's the word. You must get to a point where when you want to marry somebody, you must decide. That's why I have a problem with people who decide to marry other people on the basis of how she looks, on the basis of a private party, and on the basis of he's got money. You know what I'm, you can't build marriage on top of that, because when these temptations come, then they will sweep you alive. Because remember, when you marry a person on the basis of the money, there will always be somebody that has got more money than the one you have. What are you going to do? They want you. You're gone, because the decision was solely based on money. If the decision was based on beauty, what happened the day you realize that, the day you find a lady far beautiful than the one that you have? If it was based on sexual intercourse, what happened the day you find a lady that you enjoy the intercourse more than the one that you have? That is where I said, the decision for me to marry you as a lady, it comes from this simple thing. It comes from your character. From there, we can then look at the other external things. I'm not saying, obviously, you're going to marry somebody that, you know what I'm saying. But I'm saying, you know, as much as they are lookable, but what recommends you to marriage should not be your beauty, should not be your status, or what type of cars you're driving, should be the character. So in this case, as a man, I'm saying, I think the king must get to a point where he accepts that, you know what, there's always going to be beautiful people. So I'm not going to base my decision on the outward appearance of everybody here. I'm going to base my decision solely on their character, because we need to build a kingdom, right? We need to advance the kingdom. So what am I? Look, you know, I'm 15 wives, guys, are too much. The 15 wives, guys, is too much. It's too much, guys. Okay, but let's continue, guys. But even though former South African president snapped the meeting, Nomcebo's mother, Mam Hlongo, was allegedly present during the family as the happiest woman.
Oh, okay.
Mam Hlongo was not allegedly married to former president Jacob Zuma, but have children. It is alleged that during the family meeting, Mam Hlongo described the move by the Eswatini king to marry her daughter as a blessing. That's the end of the article. So, I have my reservation about this. Like, honestly speaking, I've got my reservation. I've spoken about three things: love, commitment, and contentment. You need to get to a point. Look, okay, let me finish this. What I was saying previously, I was saying that the decision to marry somebody comes from these three things. And at least for me, proof that you've got a good look. No, not three, no, you guys. What am I saying? Not these three things, but I'm saying that these three things are things that I think I should give, I should have in the relationship, and my partner should have vice versa. But the decision to marry somebody comes from their character. Their character recommends them. Now, speaking about their character, then this is where you and I, you know, we might have it a bit different. I don't know. But look at this. If for instance, the decision is made based on her character, no matter the beauty, for instance, you give us Michelle and Damas, even though the beauty there is not natural, it's just they went under the Caesar, you know what I'm saying, to get the BBL. But say, for instance, you are charmed by that as well. There's going to be a lady that is much more beautiful than Mihlale. So, Mihlale and Damas. So, my decision to marry whosoever I'm marrying, if it's based on her character, I think even when we are fighting, even when we are going through a lot, as long as the character hasn't changed for worse and it just develops, it's easier to even commit even further during the fight as well, during the squabbles that you are having as a couple, because it's given. You are going to have those things. It's just the problem is not whether or not you're going to have the squabbles, but the problem is how you manage the squabbles. So the point that has to be driven home in this video is that since the decision is made based on character, it is this that will then make me not to pursue other beautiful ladies that I will keep seeing. Because I must emphasize this. Guys, there are women out there who are beautiful, naturally beautiful. And you can see they compete with the best of the best in terms of their beauty. But if you can constantly pursue that, hey, you will never come to an end. Say, for instance, this is Samsung S24 Ultra, right? The latest phone. This is the latest phone. If you live for this technology, Huawei is going to release another one, theirs as well, the best that they can offer. iPhone this year, they will be releasing iPhone 16 this year, September. You know what I'm saying? You can check other brands as well. But let's say, for instance, so are you going to go and buy... This phone is worth close to something, 30,000 or something. Around then, I'm not going to give you the actual price. But think about it. iPhone is going to release theirs. You go and buy. Huawei is going to release theirs. You go and buy. Come back to cars. BMW is going to release theirs. You go and buy beautiful BMW. Are you going to get set? Look, when are you going to draw a line? You may have these phones every year. You change them. But when are you going to draw a line? You must get to a point where, despite the beauty of Huawei, but I still stick with my Samsung Galaxy S24 Ultra, right? Despite the beauty of iPhone, but I still stick with my Samsung Galaxy S24 Ultra. Because the decision to buy it was not an emotional decision. It was a calculative decision. That's why I'm saying when we make decisions, let's calculate, because there's always going to be... When you think that you have seen the best BMW, somebody... Look, BMW will produce another best one than the previous one. Mercedes, the same thing.
Jaguar, the same thing. Lamborghini, the same thing. iPhone, the same thing. Like, to get a point. In life, in general, just apart from men and women, apart from humans, just these material things as well, they keep developing. We keep seeing more beautiful things. What keeps us at bay and look, what makes us not to spend unnecessarily, it is discipline, commitment, and contentment. If you can keep it to that, a lot of relationships and a lot of people will not divorce. Just contentment.